What's up, gamers? You're gonna be learning how to take out entire enemies and camps completely with no problem. This even includes silver level monsters. So if you're not even at the silver point yet, don't worry, you'll be able to nuke so many enemies that you'll be able to reach this point in the game with this build today. We're gonna be going over the ninja build, which is gonna require a little bit of a setup. It should be no problem at all for you to take out enemies by one-shotting them. Let's get into it. The first step that we need to do is head over to Kakariko Village on your map. So I'm just gonna go to the shrine right over here and teleport there. When you arrive there, you want to head over to where the clothing shop is. This is going to be indicated by the clothing symbol outside of it. And when you open it up, you're going to see two armor sets, the Radiant Armor and the Sheikah Armor, aka the Stealth Armor. Now, Stealth Armor usually is going to cost a lot in this game because the prices are marked up because their grandmother is sick. So in order to get this item discounted at a much cheaper price, what you're going to need to do is head over to this location over here, and you're going to see someone by a fireplace talking about grandma not feeling well. In order to heal the grandmother, you're going to have to make a special porridge. All you're going to be needing is Hylian rice, fresh milk, and green in order to heal grandma. The Sundaline will count as your fresh greens. You can buy the milk and the rice from Hatino Village. There's a shop there, so pick up those ingredients. You're gonna talk to her, and then after that, you're gonna get a cutscene with grandma, and then all the items in the shop should be a lot cheaper. So then you can go ahead and buy the stealth set. Stealth will basically allow you to be able to easily sneak up behind an enemy without them realizing where you are. So that is going to be the benefit and the ninja part of it. I mean, we need a ninja outfit that has stealth. So this is going to be great. And it does help when you want to take out an enemy, because when you sneak strike in this game while wearing this outfit, you're already going to be doing some good damage. After you got your stealth armor, you are done with this step. And now let's move on to the next one. Head over to this shrine over here, which is going to be by the Akala Tech Lab. Make your way up to the tech lab and approach the door, because we're going to need ourselves some nice Yiga weapon. And the reason why we're going to need it is because this specific weapon is going to have a bonus when it comes to sneak striking, which we're going to be enhancing with our new stealth outfit. So we're just going to have to go ahead and take out both of these people, because that's the only way this battle is going to end. So perfectly lined up. There we go. They're done. And the weapons are going to drop. And if you read the eightfold blade, you can see that it has the blue text that says it yields more powerful sneak strikes than ordinary blades. So this is really important, but you can see also that it does have a low attack. And we can compare that to the eightfold blade with the silver lino horn with the plus 10 enhancement. So pretty much that eightfold blade is actually 15. So there is going to be a pristine version of that we're going to get. But before we get that pristine version, we're going to have to break the eightfold blade. So go ahead, equip your eightfold blade and just smash it to pieces if you haven't done so yet. We need to break the weapon. It can't be fused to anything. And it basically is the first time you have it. You just break it. And once we break it and it says badly damaged, it'll unlock in the depths on the ghost soldier statues. So what you want to do is open up your map now. And we're going to be heading towards the depths right around this area over here. This is going to be right below this stable over here, the Dueling Peak Stable. So this is the area where we're going to be going. This is going to be the entire area where we are going. So just go ahead and teleport over to that light route that is close by. And if you haven't found that light route, well, just have to enter a chasm that is pretty much close by. And as you get down here in the area, there is a single-handed weapon right there. This is going to be the eightfold blade that I found, which is happening because we broke the decayed version above. And this is going to have a higher attack and a higher durability. So once we get this, we're going to head out of here to our next location. Hey, real quick, if you're enjoying these kinds of videos, make sure to hit that subscribe button and like it so I know to make more like this. Now, what you want to do is head over to the Elden Mountain area by Goron City, because if you're a subscriber of the channel, you know that we love doing something very specific here, and that is going to be Octorok enhancing, right? Octorok enhancing. That's exactly what we do. So just go ahead and we're going to jump off and head over to an Octorok. Now, if you're earlier in the game, your weapon probably didn't have an enhancement on your pristine weapon. If you are later in the game, most likely you already had an enhancement on it, so you're just going to need one Octorok. So those who have no enhancements, nothing that says plus one up, durability, anything, you're going to need two Octoroks here, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. So approach your first Octorok and take out your new eightfold blade and drop it right in front of it. Just like this, and drop. Then you're going to back up, it's going to suck it up, and it's going to spit it back at you. You're going to see a sparkle, which means it is being enhanced, or if it's already enhanced, it's going to change it up. then it's going to spit it back at you. If this is your first time enhancing it, you're going to have a white or blue enhancement on it. Then go ahead after it enhances it and just kill it so it can respawn in the next blood moon. After that, we should have our first enhancement and we should be heading to our second one to get another enhancement, which is marked by these diamonds on my map. Then the Octorok is going to suck up, sparkle, and spit it out. Make sure to kill it and then pick up your weapon. And once you got your attack up plus 10, you should be good to go and your eightfold blade is going to be a lot more powerful. Now, the next step that you want to do is go ahead and you want to grab a specific part for this. You want to grab one of your silver Lynel saber horns, which you should have here if you watch my video and you did the Lynel farming. And that's going to enhance the weapon all the way up to 80 damage. So we're going to be having 80 damage. We're going to yield more powerful sneak strikes. And oof, it's going to get very powerful. But we need one more weapon before we continue on. So what you want to do now is head over to the Korok Forest. If you haven't unlocked the Korok Forest, you're going to have to enter it via the Minchi Woods from this chasm over here. When you approach underground, you'll probably encounter a Gloom Hands for the first time. And then once you arrive in the Korok Forest, it's going to be very gloomy. You just have to go ahead, head down inside of the tree, defeat a Gloom Hands in here, and defeat the Phantom Ganon. And after you beat them, the forest should be fine and should be safe to go and should be very clear and no longer in the distressed state. This needs to happen in order to do this next step. But if you already cleared the Korok Forest, you should be good to go. So once you arrive in the Korok Forest, you're going to go back into that tree area right there in the Great Deku Tree, and you're going to just ascend all the way up just like this. You're going to probably pop into another Korok's bedroom, which is a totally different quest. Also, just ignore that. Don't touch any of its flowers or it's going to get really angry at you. I touched its flower. It got very angry at me. And I'm going to go ahead and ascend up another floor. I touched the flower again. Okay, let me try that one more time. And we're going to go ascend into the next floor. You're going to talk to Korok here at the top of the tree, who talks about a treasure hunt. And then it's going to reveal two locations of the forest dweller icons that you have to find. And here on top of it is going to be the forest dweller sword. And facing right away as you come down here, around this tree, yeah, there we go, is the Forest Dweller Spear. So what you want to do here is just go ahead and break those, because the Forest Dweller Spears have a nice ability where you can attach things on top of the tips, and pretty much you can use them over and over again, but we'll show you a demonstration of them in battle. So just go ahead and break both of them. Once you have broken both of the weapons, you're going to go ahead and just open up your map, and then you're going to pan down right underneath this forest to the depths. And I marked on my map two spots where you can get the spear and one spot where you can get a sword. And we're going to go ahead and just save our game here right before we go under. That way we have a point where we can come into the game just in case we render in a ghost soldier statue if we go ahead and teleport down to the depths. Just want to always make sure you have a save ready to go that you can come back to that doesn't have anything rendered in. That's like the most important part about coming down to this area. So once we're down here in this light route, which I've shown you, which is a little further from the middle part, you're going to head over to that star icon, which I have on my map. And that star icon, like I mentioned before, is going to represent single-handed weapons. Then just go ahead and make your way right to where that ghost soldier is, which should be right behind this tree. And when you zoom in and look with your camera, you should see something that looks like that. That means you have identified the proper pristine forest dweller sword. And like I mentioned, pristine, a lot more damage, a lot more durability. So just go ahead and grab that. And while you're already here, I'm going to open up my icons and find a material called the puff shroom. Then just throw your puff shroom down on the floor and go ahead and do the fusion ability. And then that's it. You got your puff shroom on your sword. And when you whack the floor, a whole cloud of smoke is going to come up and the sword is going to refresh until you can do the next one. Now let's head back over to this light route over here, which is further north and much more closer to the center. And what we're gonna be doing is heading towards these two little markers on my map with the people icon that I mentioned. Pretty much that is going to be where our two forest dweller spears will be. So let me just head over there and fly to it. Now, if it doesn't happen to be a forest dweller spear, no worries, you can just reload from the light route area where you were. And if it constantly just doesn't show up as a forest dweller sword, worst case scenario, you grab them, throw them off of the statues, cause a blood moon, then come back and you should get lucky. On this run, I wasn't able to see any, so I just go ahead and I reload again from the Korok Grove. Okay, once you reload back into your game from the light route, we're going to go ahead and check again if our Forest Dweller Spears are there. So So I'm just going to fly over to the first one right there. And it wasn't it again. So I'm going to do one more reload. Okay, this time on my third reload, there it is right in front of me. The Forest Dweller Spear is right above. So I'm just going to go ahead and grab this. Oh, this looks so nice. This is such a cool... This is one of the best weapons in the game, in my opinion, just for initiating attacks. Let me throw this away. Don't need that. Grab the Forest Dweller Spear, and you're just going to go ahead and then fuse a Puff Shroom to it. Great. Now you have both Forest Dweller weapons, and I just wanted you to have both just to have them both. I mean, why not, right? That's the best part of this video. Have two weapons in case one breaks, because they literally do the exact same thing, but now you got two pristine ones to do that cool smoke screen effect. Now let's go ahead and show you this in action, because now you have all the tools you need. The first thing that you want to do for the strategy, now that you got all these goodies, is when you see a group of enemies, you want to just fly in or run in or jump in and immediately smash down the Forest Dweller weapon on the floor. You can also hit the enemy, and that'll immediately cause a smoke screen. Now this smoke screen is going to make it very hard for the enemies to see you completely. You can literally do whatever you want to them at this point. You can get behind them and nonstop just one shot sneak strike them. And the cool part is you can see right over here, look, we can sneak strike even a silver boss bokoblin. Boom, knocked out, completely gone. We can knock out silver moblins. Boom, completely gone. We can even knock out silver lizalfos. Boom, completely gone. And just take out entire camps one after the other. Now, the cool thing is, besides just taking out these silver ones, we can also take down level 4 constructs, which are going to be fun. So the captain constructs and the soldier constructs that are 4, easy peasy. Look at this. You just jump onto them, you see them, smash it, the smoke comes up, and you can take these ones down too. You're basically unstoppable and can farm up overworld mobs so easily, and this will raise up your experience fast as you quickly hit each camp and keep knocking them out. So you don't have to also farm big overworld bosses in order to level up quick. You can do this to get your experience up very fast in the game by just taking out camps left and right with the awesome ninja build. Now that you've mastered the professional ninja build, you should check out this video over here. Seriously, it'll help.